There's so many misconceptions about Lyme and where you can get it. So some people think that it's only on the East Coast, and some people think you can only get it in a forest. So there was a study done by Quest Labs, and it showed that Lyme is found in all 50 states. So they had blood samples from patients from every state, the entire country, and Lyme was found, the Lyme bacteria. So we know that Lyme exists in every state. Animals travel, birds fly, ticks attach themselves to birds, and people move as well. People have pets. Pets get Lyme disease. Dogs die of Lyme disease. There are blood tests for Lyme disease for pets and different animals. People bring their pets with them. You don't have to be in a forest to get Lyme disease. You can be in your backyard, standing in the grass. Ticks also like to hide in dry brush, in piles of dead leaves. And they are in bushes, they're on blades of grass. They don't fly, they don't jump, they crawl. And you can be anywhere. You can be leaning against a tree and they can crawl up the tree. You can be on a picnic bench somewhere in a park. So people have to have a high level of awareness and take precautions. You can get Lyme anywhere, anytime. And because of global climate changes, the cycle in which you can be infected and bitten has now been extended. So ticks are around for a longer period of time. It's warmer. The colder climates times have shortened. So that has all changed as well. One of the big misconceptions about Lyme is that it's only in the East Coast, and that's proven to be wrong. Another big misconception is the tick has to be attached for over 48 hours to get Lyme, and we know that that's not true. People can become infected within minutes to hours. Another misconception is that if you don't have a rash, you don't have Lyme disease. And we know that it varies quite a bit. 15 to 63% of patients can get rashes depending on what state they're in, their gender, and their age. So not everybody gets a rash. So you don't have to have a rash to have Lyme disease. There's a misconception that Lyme disease is rare. Lyme disease is not rare. It is the fastest growing epidemic in the world. It's been found in 80 different countries, and it's everywhere. The CDC had actually underestimated the number of Lyme patients in this country by tenfold. And we know that in this country, there are 18 million patients with chronic fatigue syndrome. There's 46 million patients with dementia. There's 23 million patients that have autoimmune disease. All of these patients could possibly have Lyme disease because Lyme disease triggers all of these things. So you're looking at millions and millions of patients all over this country, not just hundreds of thousands of patients. There's another misconception that Lyme is easy to treat and easy to cure, and that's not true. There's a window within which, if you know you're bitten, you're treated appropriately right away, your chances of being cured are very, very high. But if you're not diagnosed and you go a long period of time, that's when the infection takes a deep foothold in your body, in your system, and you cannot be easily cured and you cannot be easily treated. That's where the treatment becomes a lot more cumbersome, it becomes a lot more complicated, and the longer you've been sick and the longer you've gone undiagnosed, the longer treatment period you're going to require. There are many different insects that can transfer different types of infections to patients. We know that ticks carry many, many different diseases. The CDC said there's at least 17 different known diseases that ticks carry. Between the years of 2003 and 2016, the CDC actually had identified 6 or 7 new species of bacteria carried by ticks. Spiders can also carry Lyme bacteria. And there are other insects that can carry some of the co-infections that we know of, including Bartonella. So Bartonella is one of the co-infections of Lyme. It's also sometimes known as cat scratch fever. So people that have pets, also these pets carry different infections. And so if you're around animals or insects that are around animals or spiders, certain mosquitoes and biting flies can also carry a lot of these other infections. Lyme disease goes into connective tissue, it goes into ligaments, it goes into tendons, it loves collagen, and it goes into joint tissue. And in all of these different spaces, it causes massive inflammation. And the inflammation causes the destruction of the tissue, the breakdown of the tissue, scarring of the tissue, fusion of some of the tissue, and basically a destruction of all of these different types of tissues, discs, tendons, ligaments, and joint spaces. It even has been found to burrow its way into cartilage. It's that powerful of a bacteria. Patients have all different kinds of pain. They have dull pain, they have sharp pain, they can have nerve pain, muscle pain, joint pain, and it can be a direct result from the bacteria and this destructive nature. And it can be as an indirect result of all of the inflammation that the bacteria causes. One of the other common misconceptions about Lyme disease is that you would feel the bite of the tick, but a tick can bite you and it can be completely painless. There's an anesthetic in the saliva of the tick itself, and so patients won't necessarily know that they've been bitten. People think you would feel the bite, but that's not necessarily true. One of the other common misconceptions of Lyme is that if you test negative for Lyme, you don't have it. And that's one of the most dangerous misconceptions because a lot of people don't test positive for it. You can still have Lyme disease and test negative for it. And there are many different reasons for the poor tests. The tests that we have are old and they're antiquated. They don't test for all the different species. Some of the tests only look at antibodies and they don't look at PCR in order to accurately diagnose it.